this is my polka dot dropped side dress that I was cutting out earlier. What I've done with this is I've just prepared the border of this. I've attached a piece of fabric, which is the salwar fabric, and then I've laced this over with white lace. On top of that, I've put a ribbon, and then the beige brown ribbon, I've used a machine fort piece, which is which does gathers, and I've used that to make this lace. And then I've gone and put that on all the way across the bottom of the dress. Now, I've also prepared the neckline. It's V at the top and then going down straight neckline. I've put the ribbon on top of this, and I'm going to, I'll just take you through. That's my sewing area. This is the ribbon that I prepared. Now, there's quite a lot here because I've still got to do the back of the dress. And this is what I'm going to attach on the neckline as well. So basically, what's going to happen is, let's walk back. What's going to happen is that this I'm also going to attach around the neckline just to make it same as. Now, this 5-pound suit is going to be a very expensive designer outfit once it's finished. So I'm just going to show you how I'm going to attach the lace on. So I'll put the camera back on the stand. This is my ribbon, and the lace I'm just putting underneath, and I'm just doing this in one seam. So I've already attached the piece. Now, if you're not brilliant at sewing, and if you're new, then I suggest you do this on double seams. But if you have got the experience, then it shouldn't be a problem attaching these on as you're going along. It just means you're not seaming this up quite as many times as required then. Now, once I've done this, I'm going to go back and do the next seam on along here, and then do the same on the top. And once I've done this, I'm going to change the thread, and then I'm going to attach this lace ribbon on. And basically, then I've got my both front and back stitched up. And the rest of the dress is sewn in the similar manner. You'll attach your neckline together at the shoulder points, attach the sleeves, do the side seams, and the bottom is already done. And basically, that's about it. Now, with this, I've actually cut straight wide-legged trousers to go with this. And they're a similar sewing to something that I have actually done on another suit. So I probably won't record the video to that. But if you are interested, then watch. There's a white trouser which I've done prior to this, and I will upload that, and just watch that to get the idea on the trouser cut. Just a wide legged trouser, just straight. You'd call them drain pipes, really. That's what it's like. Now the video is going to become quite boring if I continue to record it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause it here, and then once I've done all the basics, I'll show you what the end result is. Now this is done from a basic amount of fabric, so I'm not using, you know, any extra fabric. The lace which I've crunched up, the ribbon that I've made in the crunch effect, does take quite a considerable amount of ribbon. So if you do buy your ribbon, then bear in mind that you do require a considerable amount. In my haste, I've just gone and stitched this in double. So I'm going to slightly unpick this before I go any further. This is the finished result of this polka dot print suit that I was making. The style of the dress is like that. I don't know what the name of this dress is, and I was trying to think of a name for it. It is a longer version of the camise, and I think it looks a little bit similar to a handkerchief, so I think I would name it a handkerchief camise. I can't think of any other name for it. So as an easy description, and for the sake of explanation, we're going to call it the handkerchief camise. It's got fine lots of details, and I'd have to actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it off the doll. That's basically what it looks like on the doll. I did put it on and model it for my mum, in front of my mum, but it was too embarrassing to put it on camera, so I'm afraid you're gonna have to just watch the quiet mannequin do my displays. Now I'm just gonna clear the table, and I'll lay it on the table and give you a guideline on what this looks like.